Hi, I'm Matt, and today I want to talk to you about proper thermometer placement. Perhaps one of the biggest issues I see when I'm troubleshooting an animal with somebody is incorrect thermometer placement. Oftentimes, I'll ask them the temperature, and they don't really know the temperature because the thermometer's kind of in a screwy place. So this is a basic thermometer, a dial thermometer, and the design of this is flawed to the point where it makes it very confusing. So the way these thermometers are designed is they come with a little piece of adhesive. You might be able to kind of see it behind there. I don't have an open one, but the adhesive is there so that you can stick it to the glass. Now, if we stick this to the glass, it's going to look really nice, but there is a critical issue with sticking this to the glass, and that is that the thermometer will give you the temperature of the glass. In this particular tank, these are our ball pythons, I don't see any of them living on the glass. Makes it a little complicated. So when you get your tank all set up and you're using a thermometer like this, what you actually have to do, and I'm gonna leave this in the package because I don't wanna rip it open, it's all nice. What you wanna do with this thermometer out of the package, of course, take it out of the package, is you're gonna lay it on the basking spot. So in this case, we would lay it on the ground directly under the heat lamp. Now, obviously that looks kind of crappy and the animal's gonna climb all over it, so you wouldn't leave it in there for the long term. You would just leave it in there long enough for it to read the temperature. Now, what I wanna do here is I wanna show you using this super dirty, beat up and aged temp gun. You can tell this thing has some miles on it. I wanna show you kind of the difference on the temperature gradients where we can see why this matters on the placement. So this is a very simple tank. We've got our water bowl on the cool side. We have no hide on the hot side. That is by design. That is because we have multiple ball pythons in this tank. Typically, you don't wanna do that because if you have a hide, they're all gonna crowd each other and they won't get enough heat. But in the pet store setting where they're here for a very short period of time, we keep the hide removed so they can get warm enough. So I'm gonna take my temp gun and I'm gonna point and click and we'll see if you can see this. And you can see our hot spot is right at 95 to 96 degrees. And if you're able to see that little red dot, that's the hot spot right under the bowl, 95 to 96. Now, let's imagine for a moment that we took this thermometer and we stuck it on the hot side on the glass. Say you stuck it right there, which is where most people would put it. Here's our problem. Our temperature there is 83 degrees. That's the temperature of the glass. So if I get a call from a customer and they say, hey, my ball python's not eating, my first question is, well, what's the temperature of your tank? In this particular situation, the customer would say, well, my temperature is only 82 degrees. And immediately I would say, oh, light bulb, your tank is too cool. You need to get it warmer so your snake could eat. However, the tank is not too cool. The tank is perfect on the temperature. So what would happen is we would inadvertently troubleshoot the wrong thing, all because the thermometer placement was in the wrong spot. Now, I wanna show you another tank where we have some branches where you can see where the temperature gradient becomes a little bit more complex as we move around. Okay, so this tank is kind of low to the ground. It's a little bit difficult to see. I'll slide over so you guys can see it a little bit better. These are our painted agamas. Now, these guys do like to climb. So in this particular situation, when we measure their hot spot, we want to measure it at the basking spot. That is the spot where the animal is basking. So if you kind of look through the screen here, I know it's not the prettiest or through the glass, you can see where they're at. These guys like to jump out of the tank, so I need to be kind of careful here. But what I'm going to do in this situation, if I'm using this style thermometer, what you're gonna have to do is lay it on the branch under the light where the animal is basking. You're probably very quickly seeing that this is really a very ineffective thermometer and you really should use something like a temperature gun. Up front, this is a little bit more of an expense, but it's highly accurate compared to something like this. Although these are very popular, especially for new pet owners, because they're inexpensive. They're inexpensive and easy, just not the easiest to work with. So going into our painted agama cage. Oh, it's already unlocked. Make sure nothing flies out of here. Whoa, he's thinking about it. He's like poisoning himself. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit this hot spot right here. And we are 100 degrees right there on that spot. Now check out where the agamas are sitting. Notice none of them are right on that 100 degree spot. This is really cool to note because what happens is these animals are gonna thermoregulate by crowding just close enough to that spot so they can hit the temperature they need to hit. So 100 degrees for these guys makes sense for a period of the day, but they don't always wanna be 100 degrees. So notice they're on the outskirts of that hot spot. So that hot spot is 100, now it's reading 103. I don't know if you can see that, 106. Now let's check out the temperature of the animal itself. So if I hit the back of that agama, he's sitting right at 100 degrees, 99, just dropped down 98. So that's how warm that agama is. This guy over here, is sitting right around 100. So they're perfect. So that spot right there is a little warm, but it allows them to get as warm or as cool as they want. Now that being said, I'm gonna shoot this temp gun right down here into the very bottom of the cage, and you can see I'm at 84 degrees. Now look, that's still basically under the heat lamp, but the direct beam of heat is obstructed by this branch right here. And so this is where it gets complicated. If you're using this thermometer and you're trying to register all those temperatures, you're gonna have to stick it all over the inside of this tank. The moral of the story, though, is whether you're using a temp gun or a thermometer, is you need to make sure you pay attention to the placement. Your temperature reading should always be taken on the basking spot directly under the bulb, never on the glass, never underneath a hide. I mean, you can register under the hide just to see what it's reading, but when you want to know if your temperature is appropriate, take your thermometer or your temp gun, point it at that basking spot directly under the bulb, and that is where you should place your thermometer or your temp gun placement.